I'm saying it. It's a crappy night.
Good morning, guys. So today has been nonstop video editing for me today. Obviously, I had to edit yesterday's vlog, and then I also started and finished editing my most recent wedding updates video, and so I'm hoping to have that up for you guys on Monday. That's very exciting. And then, yeah, I still need to film one more wedding updates video to kind of be completely caught up in that regard, I guess. But yeah, it was a lot of fun kind of reiterating and like recording for posterity all the, you know, memories and stuff from planning my wedding so far. And I can't wait to talk about, like, you know, dress shopping some more and hopefully booking my photographer like I keep talking about. I really, really hope we like them as much as we think we do and end up booking them, the ones we're meeting with on Monday. But yeah, that's kind of been my morning so far, and nothing too exciting. I know right now, since I finished editing all the videos, I think I'm gonna finally send out the emails to all of the wedding planners I was looking into the other day, because I never got around to doing that. So I'm just gonna kind of draft a, you know, blanket email to kind of say, this is our date, we're interested in day of coordination, are you available, what are your prices, yada yada, and just kind of give them an overview of our wedding. And yeah, hope to hear back from them that they're all available and kind of, you know, be able to eliminate the ones that aren't right off the bat or whatever and get some pricing information and start comparing that. So that'll be really nice to have another huge thing kind of starting to really be tackled. And yeah, I feel like we're finally catching our flow with this whole wedding thing, and we're finally, like, you know, knocking things out and getting things done. And like, it's gone from more like theoretical to like actual, I feel like, in the last month or so, because I feel like all the planning that we've done before, besides, like, we booked our venue, which that obviously was a very actual thing, but, like, I feel like everything else that I've done, all the plans that I've made are very, like, they're just, you know, like, on Pinterest and kind of planning, you know, the things that I want, but not actually, like, doing things, you know, like, booking the vendors, making the, you know, whatever we're gonna make for, you know, decorations or, you know what I'm talking about? I feel like I'm not making any sense, but, like, I feel like now we're actually doing stuff, and that feels really good. It feels like things are, you know, actually coming together and kind of becoming concrete and planned and real, so, yeah, super excited about that. But, yeah, I'm gonna go get to that right now and check in with you guys later.
Hello.
Melissa's back from work. How was your day?
It was long.
Yeah.
It was Friday. Fridays are always long.
Yeah.
Everybody at the office, apparently the jackpot is $163 million right now. So
For the lottery.
And everybody put in $1 to buy tickets.
So how much would we win if you guys won?
$13 million.
We'd get $13 million. What would you do if you won $13 million?
Hire an accountant and a lawyer.
Yeah, good point.
Invest some of it.
Mm-hmm.
Put some of it in some sort of a big interest-earning savings somehow. And buy a house, go on vacation. I don't know whether or not I'd keep working.
You'd have to keep working.
Why?
Well, because $13 million isn't as much as it sounds. It would not be, like, it'd be good to, like,
if you invest it the right
if
way.
If you invest it well, you could theoretically, yeah.
You didn't live, like, you had
$13 Yeah, it wouldn't
dollars.
Be enough to, like, bump you up seriously in, like, the living, what's the term?
If we continue to live, like, we could live like our parents.
Quality of life, that's what I meant.
We could do it right, to where we didn't have to actually work.
That would anymore. Be cool. I'd still do YouTube.
Oh, yeah, I would totally do. I would do way more YouTube. Yeah. I would go out and buy a really fancy camera.
I think I would buy a $1 million house, just outright, pending being able to afford the taxes afterwards. Because yeah. That's what, like, screws people that win the lotteries. They can't afford the taxes.
Yeah.
But, so I would buy whatever the biggest amount of house I could, still being able to afford the taxes. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Dakota, for that input. And then I would decorate the house. I'd buy all the stuff to go in the house. But again, I wouldn't go crazy. I'd probably do, like, Crate and Barrel.
Move?
Where would I move? Mm-hmm. I would love to move to North Carolina.
We'll see at 11 o'clock tonight.
Is that when it is?
We'd become millionaires.
Well, who has the numbers?
Everybody. They photocopied all the tickets, so everybody got a copy.
Gotcha. Well, that's exciting. I feel like we had such a freaking adult answer to, what would you do if you had millions of dollars? Well, I would invest strongly. I would start a savings account. I would hire a lawyer to make sure. Like,
because I've already made the mistakes with money once. I've made the mistakes without actually having any money. So, like, now that, like, if I got a ton of money, I would actually be responsible.
Oh, I've had that answer since I was, like, five. Well, I'd be like, well, I'd take half and I'd save it, and then I'd take another quarter. I was a herd. I was a huge nerd.
Herd.
Herd.
I thought we were going to say, like, a hermit or something.
No, I was just a huge dork.
We have a weird dog. This is a very weird play session that she's having right now.
Yeah.
It's not normal, I feel like.
It is. Oh, now we're grooming raccoon.
Don't look at me when you do that. So we're having baked potatoes for dinner.
Oh my god, I'm so excited.
And
lots of wine.
Do you want to watch a movie or no?
I don't care. I kind of got excited. I got like into American Horror Story.
I did too. And we can watch like one movie. We don't have to like.
Yeah.
Or we don't have to watch any. It's up to you.
We'll see.
Stop that. The thing is gross. I'm going to throw it out.
You cannot throw out raccoon.
I'm going to put it on a shelf.
Wash him.
I can't. How do you guys wash dog toys?
Yeah, I have no idea. Raccoon's nasty, but like
that
we can't throw it
disgusting.
Out.
Disgusting.
Okay, Dakota, can you not?
Stop it. Stop humping.
She's like, oh.
No. How's your goldfish? You haven't had goldfish in a while.
Oh my gosh, so good.
You guys, we used to buy Merrit, like, the giant, like,
gallons.
Things of goldfish.
I used to eat goldfish every day, like all day long.
She used to just, like, eat goldfish all day long.
Like, literally. Not even exaggerating.
She used to drink 5 cans of Dr. Pepper a day and eat nothing but goldfish.
I had a terrible diet. We both had a terrible diet. And we would eat those, like, frozen stovetop meals and, like, Texas toast. We ate Texas toast all the time, like, those frozen egg rolls and, like, oh, my God, we ate.
The only thing we ever actually made that was probably, like, healthy for us was eggs.
We did make eggs, yeah. But, yeah, we ate so bad. So bad.
Yes. Thank God we
And then I was confused when I had, like, stomach issues.
I know, right?
What could be causing those pains?
In my body for years. I wonder why my stomach bothers me. And then the second eating preservatives, it stops bothering me. I need a stretch. Need a good stretch.
Mm-hmm. Oh, careful. We need to hang that up.
I know. I gotta figure out a way. All I need to do is glue it to the mirror.
But we need to do it around those little hooky things that holds up the mirror.
Find something. I think what I'm gonna do. Is
she's like dying by
I
the
know,
way
but I don't care because she's being disruptive. I think what I'm gonna do is they have these little metal ledges that you just I think you like put them to the wall and then you slide the mirror in.
Mm-hmm.
But they're like flat so I could glue the frame right to the mirror.
Cool. You gonna go play video games?
I think I'm going to.
Okay.
I decided I wanted to let myself have a little fun today.
Yeah.
Been doing nothing but going to the gym after work and then coming home and making dinner right away, so. It's my break day. I still might even do a little workout at home.
Yeah?
While I'm making dinner.
Cool. Change of plan. We are heading to Target. We're gonna try and pick up hopefully the rest of the little cake stands for the centerpieces for the wedding, if we're lucky. I can't imagine they're gonna have all that we need there. But yeah, that's what we're gonna do, and if they don't have them, I guess we're gonna order the rest or check another Target or something. But yeah, we're heading to Target.
Why?
Why what?
Why did we have a change of plans?
Because I am stressed out about certain current political happenings. And someone decided to be super sweet and take me to Target. And what?
She gave up playing her video games.
And she gave up playing her video games.
Thank you.
Because she's the best. You're excited to go to Target too, right?
Yeah.
Shut up. She's excited. You like Target just as much as I do.
I'm very tired, though.
I know. Me too, but I also agreed she's picking the movie for tonight, and so we're going to watch a Super Duper Boy movie.
No, we will not end up watching a Super Duper Boy movie, because I'm going to feel bad for making her watch one, and so I'll pick one. That's what I always do. That's why they're always, like, boy movies whenever I pick a boy movie that, like, you would actually like, too. Because I always get, you know, all, like,
softy mile pier, and I'm like, oh, I should pick one she likes too.
You can pick whatever movie you want to watch.
But I won't. That's what I'm saying. I'm just too much of a nice person.
You are a very, very nice person.
Guys, I'm saying it. It's a crappy night. Merrit doesn't like it when I say that word.
I think it's called for.
We're not in the best moods right now. There's a lot of stuff happening, and it's scary for us.
There's a lot at stake.
It's not just whether or not we can legally be married, it's
whether or not I'm going to be allowed to see Melissa in the hospital and make medical decisions for her should she be hospitalized, or whether we're going to be allowed to do anything. I can
adopt a kid that Merrit has.
Yeah. If our children will be protected.
It's a lot. And it's scary, and sorry to be down, and sorry to be negative, but
I have been trying so hard to keep all of this off
the blog,
and I don't like...
You know what? I mean, but that's the thing, is that that is what this whole thing is about, and half the people that start these vlogs is to have a place to sit down and say what they want to say, and feel, you know, talk about this stuff, because yeah. It doesn't hurt your hand as much, because you don't have to write it. But anyway, sorry for the lack of enthusiasm tonight, if
or
there is
any
none.
Updates.
Or any updates.
We're home from Target.
We got home.
Massively unsuccessful.
We're home from Target. They did not have the cake stands. They only had the red ones. So we're going to have...
two Targets.
And we went to two Targets. We're going to have to take one of the ones that we bought and bring it back to another Target so they can order some for us. So that's not a big deal because we'll be able to get them. It was more just annoying that we drove to two Targets and neither one had them. Yeah. I don't know. We're dealing with a lot tonight over here. We're also feeling a little guilty. We live so close to D.C., but we made the decision to not go... what is it even called?
The Women's
March. To the Women's March tomorrow. It's just kind of a lot for us. And it'd be a little stressful. And not to mention the fact that I don't
really
even
want it to go.
We both really want it to go, and I am guilting myself for not going. I have a lot to do this weekend, though, because I need to apply to grad school if I'm going to be doing it for the fall. The deadlines are, like, in, like, a week. So, and I didn't realize that. We have family that's trying to go. We don't even know if... Sorry for the beeping. My microwave's done and I need to go get it. We don't even know if we'd be able to get into D.C. It's going to be crazy. And we live very close to D.C. It takes us an hour to get there from here. But no matter when you go down to D.C., there is always traffic. And tomorrow is going to be crazy. There's a lot of people going.
There's really high tensions.
Yeah. And neither one of us do well when there's, like, high tension. And it...
crowds.
Yeah. Merrit gets very stressed. And I don't get as stressed as she does. But we both have our own, you know, feelings. And yeah. It would just be uncomfortable for us. For a second, I thought I wasn't recording. I looked at the top of the screen and didn't see anything. Anyway, it just doesn't... It'd be a lot.
It didn't feel right.
It'd just be a lot of... I don't know what to call it. It would be uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Mentally? Physically? I don't know. Just trying to, like, be real and, like...
I know. I hate being such a downer.
We're not... Okay, first of all, we're not being downers. We're talking about something that's in our lives. And the whole point of the vlog is to... This is a... Sorry, guys. You know I'm bad at this whole holding the camera thing. This is a... If there is even though it is not necessarily a good thing that's happening right now for us, it the whole point of this vlog was, one, for you, us to personally remember stuff.
I don't want to remember this.
But the thing is we want to remember that there was this thing that happened.
I know.
There are this many people going to DC tomorrow to stand up for what's right, I guess.
Yeah.
So, it's a big deal, and being so close to it, we're feeling a little guilty for not going. But in all honesty, I have a feeling that we would end up sitting in traffic the whole time, and by the time we actually got down there, it'd be over. So, yeah. Anyway, that's how we're feeling tonight, guys. And we're gonna eat some baked potatoes.
Sorry I'm not talking more. I don't even have words. I'm just beyond, I don't know. I don't have much to say. But yeah, we're gonna have dinner.
We're gonna have dinner. I don't know what we're gonna watch. But yeah, that's where we're at. The whole point of vlogging is, you know, sharing everything with you guys, so we're telling you. We gotta be real.
Life kinda sucks right now.
On another note, everybody... Oh, I already told you about the lottery tickets. Never mind. We have each other. That's not gonna change. Nobody can actually physically keep us from being with each other. Nobody... Alright, that's a little dramatic there, bud. I'm trying to lighten things up. No, you're not saying anything. That would never happen. And if that ever happened here, we would move. So, we have each other.
It just sucks, because I want to, like, hold on to the hope that he just doesn't care enough about LGBT and just kind of forgets about it. But that means that the attentions are going to be focused on other issues that I also feel very strongly about, and I don't want them attacked either. I'm not going to get too into anything.
And I'm a whole, like, you know, I went to school for geography, and I care about the environment and all of that, and that's the whole other side of it that I'm, like, not even talking about right now.
And women's rights. We both happen women's to be rights. Women who enjoy having, you know, equal protection under the law. And
yeah, I mean, I'm going to go to school and get a master's and probably get a job that there's a guy that has that he gets paid more than me because of it.
Nice.
Just because he's a guy.
Oh, yeah.
I'm gonna go spend all this money getting a higher education.
Well, I'm talking about, like, reproductive rights.
Well. Anyway, let's not get too deep.
Yeah, I know, I'm not, yeah. I'm trying really hard not to get into any actual political opinions, just our experience with the very terrifying reality of what might happen to our marriage soon. That was dark.
That was just calm down over there, miss.
I'm sorry.
Goodness.
You just turn off the camera before I get, I don't know, I just...
Guess what?
What?
We love each other very much, right?
I know, but that's different, and so honey, we could do that without marriage, and honey, marriage comes with...
At least we have somebody to love and to care about and to go through this with, right?
Yes.
All right. Let's end on a good note. Yeah? We have each other. We are healthy. We have money. We have a puppy. Munchkin. We have baked potatoes that are gonna have bacon and cheese and sour cream on them. I mean, I couldn't ask for much more right about now. Maybe another puppy. I could take another puppy.
We'd never turn down another puppy.
Maybe some chocolate ice cream. How about you?
I'm not an ice cream person, but I wouldn't turn down.
No, I'm asking you what you could do with.
I don't know.
Another puppy?
Yeah, another puppy.
Chocolate covered pretzel?
This whole wedding Merrit planning wants thing a baby. Being over, I do.
That's what she wants right now. Alright, guys, that was a really long clip. But, yeah.
There it is.
There it is. I feel like it was just the other day where you put up the vlog from the election.
Right.
All right, guys. We're going to go eat. You need to lighten up. This is our relaxing night, okay?
Just because... I mean, guys, come on now.
It needed to happen.
We're just gonna, like, shove our feelings in our mouth.
Look how good this looks. I'm so excited.
Dakota's jealous. I dropped a piece of bacon on the floor and I threw it away, and Dakota gave me the most judgmental look. Like, I'm not even kidding. She was salty. Oh my god. Very upset. Anyway, we're gonna smash this.
Time for food coma.
We're gonna drown our sorrow. No, I'm kidding.
I'm not.
All right, come on now.
We'll check back in with you later. Not that I need to say that every single time we turn the vlog off, but, you know.
First of all, guys, this newest season of American Horror Story is just beyond creepy. It's, like, horrifying. Like,
even, like, this last episode, even I was like, I don't know if I want to watch this anymore.
It's like, I like Lady Gaga, but she needs to chill a little bit.
Yeah, I'm not normally one to get, like, grossed out or
creepy, but like, I don't know, like all the Saw movies, like I love them.
Yeah.
Like Hostel, like those movies are awesome. And this is just like,
whoa, Nelly. Yeah. We're still gonna watch it though. But yeah, we've just been watching that, eating popcorn. I'm tired. I'm so tired. Do you see her? She's like walking around the couch, like peering up over the ottoman, like come on. Edge. You come say goodnight with us? Come here.
No, there's no popcorn.
Sit the tuckus down. Like, I want to sit the tuckus down. I want to be front and center. You're stinky. Alright, well, I guess Dakota's saying goodnight to you guys. Alright, Grumps, you can go over there.
She's like, yeah, I'm done. Alright, guys.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm really tired. We're gonna go to bed. I'm sorry about the kind of downer. I hate bringing that to the vlog, but real
sometimes
life.
Sometimes it happens.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
Back to normal tomorrow?
Yes.
Got lots of stuff to get done this weekend. Meal plans to write.
Wedding plans to make. I don't know if I said this already, but I emailed all the wedding planners.
Yeah, you told me. I don't know if you told them.
I know. I don't know if I told them yet. But I emailed all the wedding planners today, and I'm starting to hear back from a couple of them. Only one has said they're not available. Oh, no, two. Two have said they're not available, but they both, like, gave recommendations for other ones that they really like, too. So that's kind of nice to know.
Yeah. I might go get my hair cut on Sunday.
Yeah, your hair is getting, like, way out of control.
It's not the top. It's, like, the sides.
In the back.
They're just like...
Yeah. I want to get my hair trimmed, like, sometime soon, so, like... Because I don't want to get it, like, cut before the wedding, because I'm trying to keep it, like, as long as possible, but I definitely want to get it, like, trimmed.
We can get your haircut.
Alright, we're going to go to bed. I hope you guys enjoyed today's vlog, and give it a thumbs up if you did, and don't forget to subscribe if
you
haven't
already. Give us a thumbs up if you love us.
Yeah. We kind of need a thumbs up today.
We need a thumbs up, guys.
Alright, we'll talk to you guys tomorrow.
Good night.